Everybody, you can barely see my right arm because this is easily the most notation that I've done for one of these tutorials so far. And I don't want to make it sound, I don't want to be like, it's not that hard. But it's not that hard. It's just there's a lot of it. There's some variations in here, and there's a key shift, and it's not like a four chord song. There's a fair amount of complexity. Again, if you've been comfortable with pretty much like all the stuff we've done to this point, you'll be fine. The things really to look out for is, let's see, there's a B7, which looks like this typically. When you're using a capo, it's hard to make that shape without budging the capo, so a backup way to do that would be to sort of take an A shape, slide it up a whole step, use your lower three fingers to make it, right? Remove your middle finger so that you've just got the fourth fret on two and four, and then bar chord, and then, you know, bar it. Same thing. Wait, is it? Yeah, it is. So B7 is a thing, D7 is a thing, which if you've taken a guitar lesson and learned Yankee Doodle, then you probably know this one. But if you don't, it's a D where the middle finger of the shape, the seventh, it's the seventh note, right, has been dropped a whole step. So it goes from being a D to being a C. So it looks like this. If you're thinking in terms of pictures and shapes like I do, your triangle, which is your D chord, is flipped upside down. I hope that's helpful. So, we have our B7, or, and we also have our D7. There's a D that you can and probably should add an F sharp to. what else? And there's a key change in here, so at one point, open chord bit with the E minor, C, D, and G that you know from all four chord songs becomes F sharp, minor, E, D, and A. So we'll deal with all that when we get to it. The really interesting thing that you might notice right at the start is that there's kind of two ways to start this. The one I always play is based on Villa playing, was it Mad TV, the European Mad TV? He played acoustic live at one point, and he actually opens it, and he just goes into the first verse, as opposed to the studio version, where he starts with, "Love's the funeral of us," and he goes right into the chorus, so... choose your poison. Choose which way you want to do it, and then do a choose your own adventure on these notes. But if you pluck it out, you will start with your E major and go. So the first four notes, or the top four notes. One, two, three, four. Then go back to the third note that you had played. Make a C. And then do your verse. She was the sun. Right, and you jump down to the verse chunk. Otherwise, we'll start with the chorus, which goes as follows. E minor. Wait, what are we doing? Love's the funeral of us. And you start this a little gently on the studio one. And that's where I would put in that F sharp on your D, is when you go from G, because you're descending, right, from this G note. And then when you do the second half, the plea for mercy bit, then you can go hard. The funeral so there, again, I'm thinking acoustically minded, and I will like always pluck this out. On the studio version, though, they go. So that's, it's up to you. Think about your audience, and if your audience is you, then play what you want to hear. Verse. So.
She was the sun.
We're going sad up to bright for D, and then we're going to kind of invert that on the next pass where we use a D7 instead. Okay? So E minor to D. G is also bright. Then we're sad with A minor, go back to E minor, and then complicated feeling, D7, back to E minor, and then C, thoughtful.
What's the moon painting you?
Same thing, down to E minor. Now here's where it gets a little different, play your D7, and then we're going up.
C.
Sure you have a capo that doesn't buzz.
The funeral of art and no fall, cruelty when angels cry blood.
Right? So after that, once again, I've got it in the chorus, but you're going to choose the... You're going to do that one or the... Okay, but just pick one and then you're back to your verse. After the second verse,
and you were like a moth to that flame.
You're gonna play a pass through on the chorus without singing. Second part of our bridge is actually new. See?
Theoretic seal beyond divine.
So you want to find a way to play that B7. And again, this is an option. Bar, this is actually the first B7 I learned. Whatever's easier for you. We start over.
The last rites for souls on fire. Three little words and a question why.
D. Now we're changing keys.
Love's the funeral of hearts.
And you can see I've just got an E there. Right? And then here's our little transition. These are the new chords we're going to be using, except for F sharp minor. That's D, A, E. And now we go to F sharp minor, and it'll be with us for the rest of this.
When angels cry, flowers are evil in the world. The funeral of hearts and people, the sailing love is a god, separating me from you.
And then gently close out. Just like we did with the E minor, and you have to plug this out. This is part of the end. Come up to your F sharp minor. And then while you're up here, I mean, you could just do a D, but I think it's tonally more consistent to, and it's more difficult to take your F sharp minor and basically make an open C chord on your bar. Got it? So, we'll go ahead and do a demo. Try not to take up more of your time than we need to. So,
she was the sun shining upon the tomb of your hopes and dreams. So
stick the landing. As ever, thank you so much for watching. Oh, my watch was like, do you want to set up noise notifications for when things are too loud? Yes, thank you for watching, and I hope that was helpful. If it was, give me a thumbs up or a comment or do whatever you want. And I hope that whatever you're doing, you're being safe and taking care of yourself. Thank you. Bye.